Hello everyone, and welcome to another edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials, and today I have a bonus episode about Live Story Creator. Now, this time using it in conjunction with Datalink. So whenever we use the different styles in Microsoft Word to trigger a command on the TriCaster, well, it also sends that information over Datalink that you can then embed into different graphic templates on your system. So let's take a look. Okay, so before I get into the Datalink side of things, let me go and review the cheat sheet that I made last week that helps you look at Live Story Creator in a different way. So if you're doing a broadcast TV show, comedy, drama, whatever, news, etc., this is how your typical show is going to look. So these big words here, like it's going to be your show, followed by the episode, then followed by scene, then character, action, and dialogue. Now, in parentheses next to those, I have the Microsoft style that will be used for the actions on the TriCaster, and then in these percentage signs are going to indicate the different Datalink code, which you will use within a graphic if you want to use that data into, say, like a lower third, for example, scoreboard, etc. Different ways you can apply this. All right. So now let's take a look at the script that I was working on last week and go ahead and show you some of the things that I had in here. So my title, the style for that is going to be title. Our episode title style is heading 1. Our scene style is going to be heading 2. Our name style will be our heading 3 or character. And then the action is going to be indicated by a subtitle for style. And then our text is just regular old text. I don't need to do anything with that. It is normal. Okay, so now let's move over to the TriCaster. Now on the TriCaster, I have my script loaded into my automation tab here on the right. And then in my downstream keyer number 1, I have this graphic that I've set up over here on my graphics 1 bin. And let me go ahead and open that up for you. So the first line is going to be the data that's coming out of our script. And then beneath that will just be indicating what it actually is showing off. Now if I click on these, check this out. Now you'll start to see those Datalink files that I've gathered from my Live Story Creator scripts and then thrown them into a title for Datalink. All right, and then heading 1, same thing. You'll see here, percent sign script underscore heading 1, and then heading 2, heading 3, and subtitle. All right, so let's go ahead and I'm going to restart my script from scratch. And if I click on this button here, I'm just going to show you that I have my comments and headings turned off because I don't want things to start firing off and get a little distracting here. Okay, so let me go ahead and hit play, and you'll see at the very top, the first couple things that I had on my script were the show title, episode title, the segment name, and the name of our character. All right, so let's go ahead and play out this script. So keep your eye here on the script itself as we go along. So let me go ahead and hit play. And as I get to this caret here, it will then fill in these different pieces of information that I typed into my script, like the name of my character, the intro segment title, the episode title, and the actual show title itself. All right, so as we go along, we're just basically having our talent read off the teleprompter here, and we'll get to this next caret, which has Candace, and when it gets to that, it will change heading 3 to her name automatically. So the script is now sending out either commands, or you can also send out those Datalink codes. Now I've turned those commands off like I mentioned here, but as we get to this next part, we're going to have two different pieces of information that will change, which will be heading 3 and the subtitle. So let's take a look over here, and boom, updates those automatically as well. So you can use Live Story Creator in tons of different ways, not only to trigger different commands on the TriCaster, but also to manage your different segments, titles, etc., using Datalink. So again, Live Story Creator is a super powerful tool, and you can do a whole lot with it. Now, if you have any more questions about Live Story Creator, please talk to your local reseller or visit newtech.com. And for more videos like this one, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube page at youtube.com/newtechinc. And for the latest news, interviews, and announcements from New Tech, check out newtech.tv. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you again next time on the next edition of Tuesday's Tutorials.